Nicely.
Frank?
Yes, Sid.
Quick comment here.
Congratulations to you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
You know, it's been talked about that this is important for London 2012 to have you on the executive. What do you think this means? What is the importance of this?
For me, it's a great pleasure to do it. For London, I think it must help to have somebody who is a member of both boards. You know, the executive board and the London office security board. And that's just to maintain the splendid relationships that currently exist. I mean, this is an outstandingly good organising committee that's a very professional IOC staff. We just have to make sure that they work together, work well together, and we do what we need to do.
First EB in December, looking forward to that?
Indeed. I'm slightly surprised to see the date, that it's July 1961. Which is Lord Burley, retired from the executive.
So July 1961 was the last.
Until 66, yeah. You're only the third since the First World War, Lord Aberdare and Lord Burley. So,
maybe it's a good thing we don't have three lords leaping.
But of course.
You have a moment here. Congratulations.
Thanks, mate.
You know, how's it feel? I'm sure you're very happy to...
Yeah, no, I'm very pleased. It's not easy. And you're very pleased. Big responsibility.
First time that you tried for an executive AC too, so gratifying there to win on that first time.
Yeah, it was. And big competition, so, and all of whom I respect, so... But it's it needed to be now for me because I turn 60 next year, so I've only got 10 years on the organisation, and I'd like to be able to do 8 years, and so it's just quite critical.
Anything in particular you want to bring, you want to try to do while you're on the EB?
Well, the priority for me is what I've been doing for the last 20 years, and that's making sure that the conditions for the athletes at the Games are in what's previously been just the Australian athletes, but in Sydney. Are the very best we can offer. Certainly like to do more in Oceania and use that as an example of what we can do to help developing countries. I think we've got work to do with encouraging more women. Again, we'll do that in Oceania. We're taking steps there. Continue to support the athletes' representation on all of the executive organs of the National Olympic Committees.
What about talk? Interest in another Olympic bid from Australia, 2020 or 2024, possible at all?
I think it's just not foreseeable. Our major priority is to try and win one of the two Football World Cups, 18 or 22. I'm getting away from support to that. And I think that it would probably be... another 10 or 15 years before we could seriously contemplate the Games coming back to Australia.
Better prepare a new generation then for that.
Yes, I don't think I'll be around there. So I think that's good.
Thanks, John.
Thank you.
Congratulations, yeah. See you
more often now. Yeah.